哈哈哈哈哈哈！又抽到宝剑六，超爽的啊！哈哈，好爽！哈哈哈哈哈！他写我没有乱写，我的章又在乱写。 其实里面有相当多，不科学又，但是又觉得很合理的东西在其中。逗号。但似乎又都可以接受。接受，都好。但我在看冥想雪松第一本的时候。逗号，其实心中就在想，人类跟自然之间的分际到底是什么？是什么？问号。到底应该如何去平衡？让人类去参与整个自然生态的平衡。句号。Enter。生态系的每一个角色都有其平衡的意义。而人类似乎是个相当特别且奇妙的存在。
is we're at the NATVA show, and we're going to be going through the trailer, all the new innovations coming down the pipeline. Here it is, hauling a UTV, and there it is, folded up. 100% aluminum, folds in 2 minutes, soars in 40 inches, can carry 2,300 pounds. And this is the guy that's going to walk us through it. 15 years ago, we just produced a product to the United States. And if you're finding that our first picture here, so it's a versatile line, can use it for pretty much everything. For a motorcycle, it's easy to use. And when it's it's made of aluminum. So this trailer completely folded up right there. And you have the different sizes. So we range from 4x8 to 6x12. And part of the adapter. That's the transformer. The transformer tray? Yeah. That was all from that. Hey, what is the price on this? $5,000, and depending on the size. And you can also add options for the music for new and music new lack. So we have about 15 different options. And even though you're made in Canada, you sold worldwide, or
you're such a North American one.
Okay. And this is very compact since it's a ship up. So we are looking forward to zero to possible. I do. Yeah, I'm saying. And I saw that one of the other guys here everywhere. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. Play as a scissor hoist. They've got the toolbox split in half. Keep those guys, that's the Raw Max trailer. Let's keep looking around on the way.
So basically what we've been trying to do is get a trailer out there that looks different.
Yeah. So we got no rubber rail, no tie downs on the outside. Like you've seen, you know, all the trailers in years, like 20-30 years for the moment. So we designed a wing that you can customize all your tie downs on the like tie beam frame, but the wing comes out, so the wing creates the entire trailer becomes it. For cars, you don't have nice. If any guy, but
no,
okay, it's gonna have all the details. Is that there? That guy, Casey Marks. So he was working for a dealer of ours, bought a couple of bands down, so he was going back to the dealership and getting more
on Facebook.
And pretty quickly, he was just overbooked. I think he ended up buying another. We're getting into business because he was sharing a story with them and he's starting to help others get into business.
And he just legitimately started with this setup.
Okay. Yeah, a one ton truck. You can even do it with a 3/4 ton truck. But a lot of these guys, they like to have a dually. It's just a little more planted on the road.
Yep.
You know, it's 14K trailer, rated for 14,000 pounds. So this is a 6-foot bin right here. This is the largest bin. It has 19.5 cubic yards capacity.
Holy crap.
14 to 12 and a half.
Yep.
And this one here is just under 6 yards. So this is for a concrete bus out, stuff like that. It's the heavy stuff.
Yeah.
What will often happen is you get guys, they'll fill these on 4 foot or even 6 foot size. They'll fill them up with dirt.
Yeah, you can't do that.
That's way too heavy.
You can't do that.
Light debris right there.
Any dump in my neck of the woods has got a 10-ton limit. I don't care what you put in it. You can fill it up with couch surf cushions as long as they don't weigh over 10 tons.
Right.
You're done. So that's the light debris. You know, you can do a little more weight on this 4 foot. This is for 10 tons. This is 7 inch high. 4 and 5 inches.
Like this, then you're gonna be about 35 for a trailer and a couple of bins. That's kind of the entry first. So it's kind of on a weekly basis. You'll put it out in somebody's yard, and then it's just a 1 week rental. And then he comes and he services that bin.
Full,
the landfill.
Sure, they changed everything. They've got a completely polymer ultra body. It never rusts, it never corrodes, doesn't dent. As far as I know, it never needs paint, it'll never rot. It's pure polymer. And it looks like this one is a tilt deck. Actually used a window. UT by Flow Trailers. Look at this ramp. Literally just going through the subway. I just wanted to say this. Yeah, I've never seen it. You guys are good old Minnesota company. I've never seen a polymer trailer like that. Are they dense? So this evening, can you just kind of walk me through what you guys do with these trailers so these guys can get to know you?
So who's these guys?
My audience.
Me too.
They're my guy.
Yeah, you need time?
Set up?
I don't understand what you're doing exactly. shoot live stuff? No, it's not live. It's recording, but I'm recording right now, and I was just looking this over, and you walked up, and I figured I could say, well, maybe you could point me out some features on it. I don't know if I want to be on there or not. I'm not familiar with it. Okay. I think I need to do my diligence before I just started signing up.
Do your diligence. That's a smart man, and I like the way you put that, too. So we'll let him do his due diligence, and we'll see if he comes back on camera in a little bit. Well, every now and then I have an interesting story that comes out of one of these shows, and this guy happened to be one of them, because as soon as I turn that camera off, he starts to ask me how much I get paid, where the money comes from, who's paying me, where the footage goes, and nobody will be allowed to be seen unless he has the right to review all of that footage, have editing rights before it goes live, and then I get to post it for you guys. And you guys know that even me just telling you this story right now is kind of getting me torqued, because that is never going to happen. My job is to never worry about making a company look good, bad, or in between. They can do that all on their own as far as I'm concerned. But coming down the pipeline, we've got a video about the ultimate dump trailers, like the Transformer trailers. Like you've seen the trailer earlier in this video, the Transform. Well, there's a dump trailer that does almost something similar but different, and that's coming up down the pipeline. And I hope you guys like trailers as much as I do, because I love trailers. I love me some trailers, guys. God bless. Go get them, and we'll catch you on another one, you guys. Oh, that's freaking cool. Tells you everything. Okay, can you see all these signs next to the park? And you got numbers next to that. Is that like a different C cross or something? I've always wondered exactly what that looks like. Do you love my hair? 1953 military geek. We got a pretty full show, but let's just check this out. That is fun stuff. Dirt monkey. I've heard this before. You claim to be a farm kid, but you bring your farm, we would raise maybe 20 or 30. What do you do when you pump it off? Yep. Until it right back into the top. So you're taking all that concentrated organic matter and reusing it on the field. Yep.
And you have everything right there.
And this floats. This floats, right?
This is your float. Each one of those red pops with all about 12,000 gallons a minute. A lot of velocity behind.
Okay. 12,000? Wait a minute.
12,000
gallons a minute. That would rip the flesh off your skeleton right there. You got it.
What we're trying to do is shorten the duration time.
Yeah. Do you rent these?
Yes. Our dealer network for rentals.
Okay.
What we're trying to do is keep the fuel consumption down on amperage.
Awesome. Kevin, thank you.
So welcome.
I wonder if JCB actually makes a tele payloader. Because I got the tele skid and the tele handler. So the JCB is actually the same as my Volvo. So that one is new in the industry. That one we just seen. I guess this one has been out. Let you walk around. Take a look at that big giant cat engine on that bad boy. Shkadoosh. Oh my god. So these are the floats right there. Like a kid in a candy store. What do you guys think?
What the?
Okay. What am I missing with this one? I love trying to figure this stuff out. What is this blue one? Looks like the design of a manure spreader. It's got a chain. It's got a live bed, obviously, on the bottom. You guys can see that. Big fat float tire, so it's meant to go in the field and distribute the weight. It's got a catcher up front, so whatever is towing it. Hey, can you guys tell me what the heck this thing is? Okay, I was going to say this is the fanciest manure spreader I think I've ever seen in my life. Because the ones I grew up on, they were old and wood, and they didn't look anything like this. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
They redid the commander model this year.
What did they do to it?
They made it more like a fabric, so it's more like a trail, a little bit more compact, a little bit more sporty looking as well.
Okay.
Completely redid the entire body design.
Is it still a work?
Yeah, yeah, it still has a bed in the back, and then actually the motor, so it looks super fun.
Why would it have a problem?
Yeah, so where the motor on the commander was before was kind of center, they moved it back, so it's not so loud, and then you don't feel
the heat. Oh, so for operators, it wasn't having issues.
No, okay.
Love it. Only a farm pass. That's the way we talk. I think I want this. I think I want it, you guys. Yeah, that's nice. Outlander 6x6. This may not be new, but how many times do you get to see a 6x6 four wheeler like that? Me never. I think it was my first time ever seeing it. Actually, thank you. Oh, yeah. Hauling 7 bales of hay. That's not bad. That's a nice cargo space. I've never really looked at a Can-Am that close, but lots of options for the guy that actually has to make a living with their toys. What? What did I just see? Is that got a door over on that side?
What?
A door on the bottom. Flip that open. Hold on. Let me just see if this goes all the way through. Yes, it does. Look at that. Holy crap. That's pretty cool right there, isn't it? Dirt Monkey, like Farm Fest. 48 row disc chisel, I think is what you guys call it. No, this is a disc chisel. Right here. Is that also a disc chisel? Yeah, it's got to be the same. It's just got different. It's got a different setup. You guys ever do that when you're going down the road? You see some people. Oh, I got it now. Just amazing. Giant drone right up there. But what we're looking at, I call this the one and you're done trailer right here. So this not only provides fuel for your equipment, it also has onboard DEF in a separate container, because a lot of you guys run over 74 gallons and don't have DEF. You don't want to run and grab DEF. This trailer by Thunder Creek has a DEF here. Plus then here's your fuel hose right here, your fuel reel. They keep it separate. And then in the back, looks like we've got a separate storage container for tools, gear, equipment. It's the truly one and you're done by Thunder Creek. Multi-tank trailer, oil, grease, reclaimed coolant, DEF, and diesel. Here we go. Research right here. We've got online electrical right here with a generator system and air compressor as well. What the? Oh, air, power. What is this? That is a nice setup. MTO 690. Here's your fuel and glass. And then your DEF is up front. Hey, can I ask you guys a question? What does this trailer run? 54. Okay. Yep. Just laid it. Thank you. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. There you go. 54. 500 feet here.
Brand new for 2021.
Okay.
This has been a historically number one seller for Bad Boy, but this year we added independent suspension, so each axle actually pivots individually. It has about 3 inches of travel on the wheel. It allows each wheel to move independently. If you hit a hole with one tire, the whole front of the bore doesn't dive or rise. Keeps your cutting the pipe nice and level.
Mm-hmm. So this side, if you hit a hole here, this side will go down. It won't impact this side, so that you're okay. So this front axle is no longer connected together.
Correct. We have two individuals.
All right, and that's new by Bad Boy, and that didn't affect the price.
Correct.
Just intimidating to look at, isn't it? Just look at that and I think, what would you do if this thing broke down out in the middle of the field? How would you go about fixing that stuff? All right, there you go. Let's go check out what we need $500,000 to look at for. Okay, joystick and foot pedals, Kobe was saying. Ooh, right on the seat. Oh, boots. So think about this, big work boots. You don't wear Cujo work shoes, your farmers are wearing work boots. I mean, I don't know what the farmers wear, but here you go. Well, up and down, he must be used to it being a little forward. I'm going to guess the seat is adjustable. Booyah. So that's going to not be a factor. So then you can adjust this joystick, probably the whole console. Yep, look at the whole console adjust right here. So you can raise and lower the entire console up and down. There you go. That's the case for you. So you guys can check it out when you're out doing your farm tractor shopping. Look at that track system on there. I like how it looks like it'll contour and adjust instead of being a hard track system. It's going to allow you to go up and over and bike better, I'm going to guess. I'm going to guess that's the concept behind that track system. Well, we'll walk up into the cab of this one here and take a peek at this one. Hey, guys.
How you doing?
Good. How are you guys doing?
Pretty good.
Hey, nice to meet both of you. What did you think of it?
Good.
Yeah? What do you guys run?
We got John Deere 6600.
Okay.
We got 8820 and a 77.
Okay. All right. And cab layout, what did you think of it?
It's definitely different, but I've never really ran anything. So they're all different.
How many acres do you farm?
We got about 150.
Okay.
We're just small.
Yep.
150 acres, both 150 cows.
150 cows?
Yeah.
Dude, that keeps you busy right there. You milk 150 cows.
Yeah. Okay.
What's your guys' names?
I'm Ben.
Ben and Joe. You guys mind being on the YouTube channel? Cool. All right. All right, there you go. Thanks, guys. I'll check this out. Have a good one, you guys. All right, let's go up in it. Right, how's this one going to compare to the K-Ace Combine? Not as adjustable. Not as adjustable. I notice we don't have as much space behind us. Okay. This is the view. This is your office. Become a farmer, and this is your office. Anybody know how much this costs? Five? Everybody thinks half million. We're just going to go with half. You can run over a lot of cars with that tractor. Is that the wrong thing to think as soon as you see something like that? That would be my answer. Why does it say camsole all over it? Is this a camsole? Were we there? I don't know. We gotta find out. No, this is not a camsole. Perfect cap.
Wrap up your ankle. We have a black bar on the front of the back seat, so double the diamond too. And then it comes with the bolt-on side, so you can take it off if you're using it for brush or anything longer than the bucket. Step here, we feed the grapple bolts together. That can avoid the pinch point. As well as we come with the bridge resistance leaving on the hoses and the top couplers. The grapple hooks, they also go until they're like snug down, you know, they operate independently. And all the points are useful too.
Yep,
they go at the same time, but then, like, if they one snug and the other's not, it would be going close. This is a 68 inch. $31.68. That comes with a 2-year warranty and a
30-day check. Sounds like he's trying to get a date and a rock bucket out of the car. Oh, you know, this reminds me. If you guys enjoy videos like this, and you appreciate the fact that I'll take my entire day to run out into the country and cover a farm show that I don't know very little about, but I hope you guys get some entertainment and enjoyment out of it. You know what you could do is just hit that like button. It's just a button right up underneath the video, probably down below the video. I'm thinking, right? It's a thumbs up. That's what you want to hit. You hit that for me, I'll send you free cake and ice cream. That was a total lie. But you still should hit the like button. How you doing?
Good.
Nice to meet you. I'm over here picking on Bobcat. I'm sorry. Are you the Bobcat guy with the Bobcat shirt on?
Yep.
Okay, what I was saying is those tracks don't impress me.
They're better for like in dry dirt. Better traction that way.
What are those? 16 inches wide?
They're 12 and a half.
I was gonna say 12, but I'm like,
you can get
the wide ones. Well, how wide are the wide ones?
16, 18. That's machine, I think, is 16.
Okay. Okay. Is a Bobcat anything new with these machines in the last year or two that you can walk us through?
Both of the R series, so they kind of changed the way they had to put them there.
Okay. Why did they do that, you know?
Different reasons. Like, well, I think it has to do with getting room for the emissions.
Well, bigger age. Wait a minute, emissions on the 74 over horsepower machine. There's not emissions coming out under it. It's coming out under it.
I don't know if they're gonna, so I don't really know the true reason.
Man, if there's emissions on 74 horsepower, yeah. Well.
Yeah.
Man, this is taller than look at this thing. So here's the cutting edge right here. So let's talk about edge punch and center punch, you guys. This is something you should know because now this cutting edge is flippable. You're going to get twice the life out of it. Pop all these bolts out. You take this back cutting edge and you put it up toward the front when this thing wears down. Okay. 3/4 inch teeth, reversible cutting edge, 76 inch opening. So that would be high capacity, so 8 foot. So that would be from here to here. This unit is, I don't know if that's an 8. Is this a 7 or an 8 foot? 7 foot. So this is $3,700 delivered anywhere in the world. To France? Tyler, get the Top Gun sunglasses on. He's ready to rock and roll.
There you go.
Well, Tyler, this one, how far would I want to go? Well, basically, Tyler, all I want to know is what's the basic differences that a guy should look for when they're buying a pressure washer so they know what they're getting and what they're not getting. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just want the brief summary on these things.
Well, I mean, right here on this one's going to be referred to as a gas cell. This one's operated off of a Honda engine and it runs a 12-volt battery. So if you don't have a 220-volt electrical outlet near you, or you want to go out and do on-site or build a trailer to do mobile washing, this is what you would probably use and set it up and put in a trailer that way.
Okay.
And then after that one, we're going down to have a bit more of a station that's going to help your natural gas. You don't get natural gas at your site, your shop, and you're always going to be washing in one consistent spot.
Mm-hmm.
If you're doing trailers, trucks, buses, heavy equipment, machinery, you're always going to have your machine in the same spot, and you don't want to worry about running a diesel burner inside of your shop. You know, you didn't help your natural gas one. 220-volt electrical power to it. Works out just great that way. It sits in the same spot and runs real good.
Okay. Dude, you're awesome. Keep going. All what right. Do you need to know?
Down here is what we have is our diesel fire. They can run off number one diesel, number two diesel, or even kerosene too. And these ones can make a variety of different sizes and styles, from, you know, from small little, maybe you're, you know, you have small hobby farmers, you can roll it down so you don't need as much pressure above farming. Then you go for a little bit bigger, much more intermediate, or, you know, heavy cake out of grease, rope dry, you know, manure spreaders, things of that nature. So that's where 20 volt electrical farmer one behind these like here. So you then you get up to a little bit bigger one. Let's say you have a cement company, where you have a cement cake down, and you're hauling, you know, any sort of heavy, really, really cake down stuff. You need higher pressure, but still need a lot of water flow to you. That's basically the breakdown. And, you know, you can't bring anything with us here, but we still have one that's a little bit more higher power as two that have more water on the flow to it also.
So I would personally need the portable unit. What is that gonna run?
Well, in a portable one like that, you know, ours are all industrial built. Everything ours is industrial. It's made built to last.
So where he's saying right now the price tag keeps going up.
Unfortunately, yeah. When you get industrial and want things that are built to last, you're going to pay a little bit more of a premium than saying if you get what you pay for.
Yep.
So a machine like this is going to run you $6,250. And you know, for us too, that includes your pressure washing hose, 50 feet of it, your 3-foot gun line, your 3 different washing nozzles too, and a chemical injector. Everything you can start washing.
Pretty much a plug and play then, right?
For lack of better terms, yeah. It's a plug and play.
I don't see a trailer hitch. This is not a tow behind. You actually have tow behind units?
We do not have tow behind units.
Okay. All right. So you throw this in the back of your truck. You got a little parking brake right there.
Yeah, brake on it too. Yeah. You make this one too. Underneath the wheel, you can actually take the wheels off. You have a little rubber foot mount and J, but you can actually mount this and bolt it straight down to a pallet in the back of the trailer. Go in the back of the truck if you want to do that one.
Cool. Okay. You rock it.
All right.
Thank you. Have a good one.
Ooh, Altaz.
Now, Altaz actually has a stand on tracked mower, but I don't see it here.
Oh, here it is. Right in front of me.
Look at that. Dirt, 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 dirt. Check that out. 61-inch all-terrain HV deck. All-terrain. Impressions? Heavy duty. Just well built. I'm looking at the front casters. I'm looking at that front system. And I can't. I've never driven one, but.
Hey, what's that? Do you work here?
Is there. What's the purpose? I mean, what was this designed for, I should say?
Serious terrain. Serious terrain. These things will mow hills that a wheeled mower can't even consider being.
Right, right. But I mean, is this more like a brush mower? Because I'm looking at the front.
It is.
I'm looking at this going, that's more like a brush mower.
Or like mowing, you know, stuff that you mow once or twice a year or whatever. That you need to mow it, that's your upgrade.
I love it.
Water, deep slope, you know, go down
Pitch on the back, off you want.
For hunters, as far as, you know, keeping their properties up, shooting lanes through the brush, all those things, this can do it. Snowmobile club, our local snowmobile club, it took our mowing from over 100 hours a season to get the trails prepped to down to 25 hours a season. And we mow the same amount of miles with this as we used to do with Cycle Country Rough Cut Tow Behind an ATV and mow the trails. This does it way more efficient.
There's a method to the madness.
That's what I'm seeing. They start to come together.
You know? Your extreme of extreme mowing conditions. You know, for a person with a flat drive, well manicured lawn without any steep slopes, you know, not a big consideration for the mowing.
You want that
one to make sure property people that have steep slopes going down to their lakes and they want to keep those boats looking nice. Now that all the boats coming by and say, ooh, what a nice property. Well, then we get into more of that 561 with a turf pack versus something like this. That's a finished cut where this is a rough cut.
So let's take a look at what Will's talking about. He's talking about the deck system here. I'm going to grab my camera out of here. Sorry, guys. Didn't want to be in your way. Pretty cool mower, isn't it?
Well, what is that? What is it doing?
So there's an end-up version right here. 561, it's 15,599. It could be this here right here. Oh. The sit-down ones are the TRXs, and they come in three different versions. This is more of a finish cut, and this is also more of a finish cut, and then this is the all-terrain. Super rough.
Is that that one right there? Hey, I didn't catch your name.
Will,
nice to meet you. I'm Sam. So that's this one, what Will was talking about. You run a Kawasaki on them, Will?
These run EFI Briggs back air.
Oh, so no choking, no priming.
Yeah.
That'd be fine.
That being the all position conditions that EFI is better at. You start tilting carburetors at angles like this and they don't like that. EFI.
All right, that's up new by Altaz, you guys. Calling my name, you guys. The Hydromax Double Link Cantilever Port Industries, whatever you call the rest of it. I was literally reading a sign, but I call that thing cool.
And the best part of all of this,
he puts it on a trailer and tows it with that truck. Psych. That's a GMC. It's not a Ford. Get that thing off. Hey, look at, they're inviting me up into the jam. You guys get that invite? Can I go up in there and take a look at the Hydromax? Can you guys walk me through it? Would one of you guys show me what's going on with it?
What do you mean?
I'm Sam.
Sam?
Nice to meet you, Sam. I know nothing about this. I'm shooting a video on the coolest gear and equipment at Farm Fest, and I was walking way over there when I saw this. What do you guys call it?
It is a trencher.
Okay, but I know it's a trencher, but is there a specific kind of trenching application?
Well, it's for drainage tile.
Drainage tile, okay. So it's a deep trencher, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
It'll trench 8 feet deep.
How wide?
This one will do up to 29-inch wide cut, and down to 9-inch wide cut.
How fast does it go? I mean, when you're trenching, how many feet can it lay per minute, what I'm getting at?
4. 9-inch wide trench, 4 foot deep, 1.1, 1.2 mile an hour.
Good.
That would be 110 feet.
Man, that's getting the job done fast, isn't it?
Yeah.
Wish you guys could see it. This is the coolest thing ever. I'm bringing in, but the sign right here is no camera allowed. Sorry. There was 3 of you like just fooled. And there's like 4 of you that watch my channel, so that's like 100%. Alright, so let's just check this out. Pivot, right trigger. So we have the, it tells you everything that the controls do right here. But your working unit is over. So you steer, and steer here, and all the plugs in the back, getting it up front, probably in the rear. Yes. Pretty lucky to be able to say you ran one of these. There's not a lot of people that say they have, so if you are one of those guys that has ran one of these, then you can say you've done something like this. Count yourself lucky. Well, a lot of times, guys, we don't count our blessings. Little things like being able to run farm equipment, not being able to run something like this. A lot of guys that watch this channel, just because they don't get to experience what you do.
Rental center, and I have is the instructions. So go through and read all the detailed instructions when you get ready to do. We've been up, and what I've learned, there may be so, 18 inches, and that's what I'm going to put my phone. So, keep me any lines at all right here. So, I hope you get the 4. So, you'll get notification. Thank you.
It's the ultimate machine for the build higher trenches in rural areas using a conveyor belt, which is displayed on the right or left side. Tank trenches compared to other alternative methods prove to be more cost efficient and also have adverse environmental effects. Many shapes and sizes, you can change the use of big trenches in the small, shallow or deep, with up to use in a war zone. Without worthy, remarkable. At 75 feet, this massive machine produces the lowest of 8 is the heaviest of them all. This machine takes you a step above having to load an uptick machine, but this time around it, rock mine. For years, the drill and blast method was the only real way to blast through walls and walls of rock. And this has been years of no resolve when trying to make something simple to rock. Fortunately, in 2016, us had work sites, making it easier to excavate sharp breakaways and crossbows. This unique design of this extreme machine has a state-of-the-art cutting tool, which enables each big attack of the equipment this rock produces less heat exchange, thus limiting the wear and tear of the equipment. This is a game changer for the world. Speedy snowplow. If you ever wondered who, pay attention. Let's talk about the rotary snowplow. Invented by the Western Pacific Railroad System, this giant snowplow actually started as an attachment that goes onto the front of the locomotive. All the tracks are blowing the snow high up into the air, up to 150 feet or more. The rotary snowplow has taken 2 phases. But it is safe to say it takes about a small army to move the rotary snowplow, some coming in at 17 feet horizontally, 11 feet tall, and others having 50,000 self-propelled working weights with specially designed blooms, clouds, and winds. More attachments are not even more features, such as rake de-icing, a snowblower, and a fully enclosed climate control pad. Make sure the pad is equipped with settings as well worth the muscle it takes to move it each year. The modern lumberjack. It started with the world's most massive tree crusher, but this next extremely massive machine takes tree chopping to the next level. It's grabbing the trees from the root and bringing the tree limbs up, but the plants and herbal can simply cut a 5-foot tree down to a log in a matter of 20 seconds. The speed of this machine is better than chopping the log. Then we've even had a tree. A 60-horsepower chainsaw is attached to a hydraulic arm. Once the hydraulic arm is attached to the tree, it slices through the tree as smooth as a knife would. It even takes it a step further by allowing big tanks to manage it, such as the design of length, cuts, and quantity of logs to be managed from your smartphone and tablet. The machine is so complex that it's almost similar to training to get employees more familiar with operating the actual machinery. Well, that's not necessarily a job you want to be thrown into. With the modern lumberjack, this massive beauty has been around since 2013, and is here to stay. The Godzilla saw. We reviewed extreme machines that cut through trees, but let's talk about cutting through mountains. That's right, the Godzilla saw can scoop up to 4,500 tons of mountain coal per year. The average saw is used to cutting through wood and other lighter material, but this saw is the epitome of extreme. Well, I still don't think that this is as extreme as the giant tree shredder, since its maximum speed is only about 1.6 kilometers every 2 hours. But the amount of punch this machine packs is worth the time. The name Godzilla comes from the massive size of the gadget, towering in at 300 feet tall and weighing over 45,000 tons. You see where they get the name from. It sure hates to be taken on a mountain when this thing is around. The machine, much like the well-known Godzilla, can and will easily crush anything in its way. Caterpillar's trusted brand delivers tough equipment that promises performance and long life, no matter what your conditions are. It's powerful, high-performance engine is the perfect balance between full economy and efficient design. Even the wheels on this thing are torqued to 2,300 pounds. This big set of nuts and bolts needed for just one set of controlled rear axle-mounted panic.
乱人类选择什么，或者是做什么？什么？逗号。其实都在参与整个大自然的平衡系统呢。问号。如果这一切都是上帝的旨意，逗号，那结果似乎就是如此。句号。 因为大灭绝是一种再平衡的方式。维持现存的平衡。当然也是一种方式。 什么东西？头发。可。可可，等一下，先休息。